Welcome to the CartonCloud Customer Overview videos. In this series, we will cover how to manage consignments, purchase orders, sales orders, and view your invoices. This video is about managing consignments. Here we will cover creating new consignments and documentation, confirming your online bookings through a manifest, checking on the status of your consignments, and finally, how to retrieve a POD for your consignment. Let's get started. We begin with the dashboard screen, which is the first screen you see when you log in. Here you can view your recent activity of consignments, their current progress, and your recent billing history. To add a new consignment, select the transport menu, then consignments. Once the screen has loaded, select add consignment, and you'll be taken to the new consignment entry page. The first thing you'll notice is a note saying consignments will be saved as a draft and you will need to finalize them in a manifest. We will show you this later in the video. Select the type of consignment you want to book from the options available. In this case, delivery. And then enter your reference number for this booking. Typically, it's an invoice number or an internal number out of your systems. Please note that this reference is a mandatory field and must have a value. Next, we record the pickup details. If the goods are being dropped off at the depot, select this option. In this case, the default pickup address has been saved in the system. It will populate automatically. However, you can change this or add a new address required. You have the choice of selecting whether to deliver the goods or for their collection from the depot for the delivery. In this case, we'll enter in a delivery address and select from the list. Again, if this does not exist, you're able to create a new address. Next, we'll enter the quantities for this consignment. In this case, 2 cartons. As this is the first consignment we are booking today, we'll select create a new manifest. However, we can associate this consignment to a recent manifest by selecting add to existing. Finally, we'll look at some of the advanced options, which you may or may not need. First, if the goods are to be passed on to an on-forwarder, select their details here or add a new on-forwarder address. If the consignment is to be added to a specific delivery run, select from here. If the consignment requires cash on delivery, then select this option. If the consignment has a specific delivery date, select that, or the default will be ASAP. The product type determines how these goods should be managed and the charges that apply, and finally special instructions that are attached to the delivery address and can be updated and saved against that address for future reference. Now let's add another just to repeat the process. Again, we start by entering in a unique reference out of your system. The default collect address is pulled through. We enter in the default delivery address. If we need to, adding a new one. Entering in the quantities, in this case, 1 pallet. Adding it to the existing manifest we've already created with our first booking, and save. This takes us to the details screen of the last consignment. Here we can print a consignment note, although this is not required with CartonCloud as it's an electronic system and the job will be passed to the driver via his mobile phone. But labels are very helpful, and here we can print labels based on the quantity of items on the consignment. This assists the driver when collecting and delivering the consignments to identify the items that belong to a consignment. Also support selecting multiple consignments at a time, like the last 2 consignments we've just booked, and printing all the relevant labels in one go, which is much more efficient. Finally, we'll move on to confirming the consignments that have been booked under this manifest. The manifest is created automatically and recorded as a draft. We can find the draft manifests and view them. We can view the consignments included on this manifest, including the pickup consignment that was automatically created for this manifest. And then we can finalize the manifest, entering in the total number of pallets for this manifest, which updates operations to let them know the consignments are ready for collection. The final step is to print, if we haven't already, the labels for all the consignments on this manifest. One click will automatically produce all of the labels relating to each of the consignments on this manifest. The next step is to be able to monitor consignment status. We do this by returning to the consignment screen, where we can see all the consignments, and in the status column, the status relating to each consignment. This is updated live and in real time. We can see some examples: awaiting pickup, delivered, in warehouse, and finally in transit from warehouse to delivery. Once a consignment has been updated to delivered, the POD is available for viewing. To do this, click on the consignment. You have two options of where to download the POD. When you click on either option, it will produce a PDF document with the electronic signature embedded in the document, showing you the name of the person that signed and the time and date it was actually delivered. This concludes the overview of managing consignments.